before we start doing computation, it's useful to learn how numbers are represented in a computer. So I'll do that in this lecture and in the next lecture. Numbers are represented as binary numbers, but to understand what a binary number is, you should first understand what our usual number system is. That's called decimals. And decimals use digits. So the digits in the decimal system are our usual 0, 1, 2, all the way to 9. Digits, as a word, as an English word, also means your fingers. Your fingers are your digits. And the base 10 number system became the main number system that we use simply because we have 10 fingers and we use 10 fingers to count. So our actual number system is called a base 10 positional number system. And the meaning of the positional number system I can show you by example. So if we have a number which we would call 524.503, what is the actual meaning of a number like this? It means that where the number is, where the digit is in the number represents its value. That's the position of the digit. So here, the 5 here actually means 5 times 10 to the 0, 1, 2 times 10 to the 2, which is 100, right? And the 2 means 2 times 10 to the 1. And the 4 means 4 times 10 to the 0. And then the 5 means 5 times 10 to the minus 1. The 0, which is a great invention, is actually just a placeholder here. And that means 0 times 10 to the minus 2. And finally, the 3 means 3 times 10 to the minus 3. So the position of the digit in the number then represents its value. Okay. That's the meaning of a base 10 number. One of the greatest inventions ever, because before that you might know Roman numerals, Roman numbers. Very difficult to do arithmetic with Roman numbers. But the base 10 positional number system allowed the easy to do addition, multiplication, division, everything you learn in grade school. Okay, so computers don't use decimals. Computers use binaries. Okay, and the binary then makes use of bits. The bits are just 0 and 1. Then the binary uses a base 2 positional number system. So as an example, the number 101.011, in the same way that we did the base 10 positional number system, the leading one here then would be 2 to the 0, 2 to the 1, 2 to the 2. So it would be 1 times 2 squared, which is actually 4. That number represents 4, plus our placeholder 0 times 2 to the 1, plus 1 times 2 to the 0. So the 101 here means in our digits it would be 4 plus 1, which would be 5, right? But now we're not using digits, we're using bits. And then this point here is called a binary point. In base 10 we call it a decimal point. In binary we call it a binary point. And then we have plus 0 times 2 to the minus 1, plus 1 times 2 to the minus 2, plus 1 times 2 to the minus 3. So this last one here would mean 1/8 in our digits. Okay? So computers are using binary. There's kind of a funny thing that happens when you represent numbers using either the decimal point or the binary point. In decimals, this is called repeated decimals. So let me show you the number system that we're most familiar with first. So repeated decimals. So it's a peculiarity, that's a tough word, of the number 10, that it factors into 5 times 2. So fractions that have in the denominator multiples of 5 and 2 can be represented exactly in decimal. For example, here 1/2 we know is 0.5. 1/3 cannot be represented exactly. 1/4 can. 1/4 is 0.25. 1/5 is okay. That's 0.2. And 1/8 is okay. 1/8 is 0.125. So these have finite decimal expansions. But other numbers cannot be represented exactly. So as an example, we have 1/3, everyone is familiar with, is 0.333333333 forever, right? So this decimal expansion is inexact in base 10, right? Other ones are inexact. A particular nasty one, which I'll show you, is 1/7. 1/7, you know, I would never remember this. 0.142857. And then this whole thing repeats indefinitely. A very nasty one. Okay. We have the same problem in binary, so repeated binaries. Right? Here we have 2 is the only factor of 2. So the numbers like 1/2, which should be 0.1. So I'm going to write the digits on the left, but I'll write the binaries on the right. 1/4 then is 0.01. And 1/8 is 0.001. Okay, let's look at the 1/3 and 1/7. So 1/3 using a digit on the left. In binary, 1/3 is 0.01, and the 0.1 repeat indefinitely. And then 1/7 is not as nasty in binary. 1/7 is 0.001, and the 0.001 repeat indefinitely. Okay, these type of numbers here are going to be called inexact because they cannot be represented exactly on the computer. And the presence of inexact numbers can then lead to round-off errors. That's one source, anyway, of round-off errors. But most of the time, it doesn't matter, because the precision of the numbers you carry on the computer are good enough that the error occurs way down in the precision, and it doesn't really affect your calculation meaningfully. But it's something that one needs to be aware of. Okay, so let me summarize. I want to show you in this lecture and the next lecture how numbers are represented in a computer, so you have a good feeling for the errors that can occur when you do computer arithmetic. Here I show you, for those of you who may not remember, how a decimal number is represented. This is the base 10 positional number system. And we have these digits, 10 numbers, including the zero. And then we can extend that to the binary number. The binary number has just two numbers, which are called bits, a zero and one. And using zero and one, then you can represent any number using the binary point. Furthermore, some numbers cannot be represented exactly with a finite number of numbers here. In base 10, a finite number of digits, including 1/3, we know repeats as 0.3 indefinitely. And the same thing is true in binary. Certain numbers then cannot be represented with a finite number of bits. We know that a computer is finite, so that will lead to one source of round-off errors in computer calculations. These numbers that cannot be represented exactly are called inexact numbers. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.